that are warm, safe, dry. They are the bare minimum for school renovation. So when we're looking at the high school, we're not even looking at extending the library, say, for example, putting a steel fascia in front, you know, creating all of these great 21st century spaces. We're not looking to do, like, say, what Lincoln did with their $60 million bond. They're renovating and recreating the building to a different standard. We're looking right now, because it is a good hospital, it is a good building, it has good structure, we're looking at just renovating what's in place and improving the electrical, the plumbing, the HVAC, those bare minimums. Now, what RIDE requires under the new regs is that the town, as we submit this, commits to a warm, safe, dry standard. So as we put together the Jacob stage, priority one, priority two items, we have to have schematics and a price to address those items. Communities have to fund within the 5-year period at least 50% of the priority one and priority two items, the warm, safe, dry standards. If they can't fund at least half of it, we're kind of, we won't be considered for future renovations, future reimbursements from the state. So right now, LNCD, SMMA, they're going through all of the priority one and priority two items, and they're really fine-tuning it. So we should have a package of information, what we're looking for as a district, to take care of those items. Now, RIDE recognizes that this is a heavy lift for communities. So what they've done, they've put incentives in place. So first incentive that we can look at for, I'm calling it phase one, that's the Hallowell and high school renovations. Phase one of this, we will be eligible for rolling reimbursements. So in the past, we used to have to do all the work up front, and then the following year, we would get our reimbursement. What RIDE is restructuring now is that you submit monthly bills, you get a monthly reimbursement, which makes the cost of the project easier, and it also allows you to reinvest. So either you can use it to draw down your debt, or you can use it for continuous reinvestment in facilities. Number two, RIDE is, one of the incentives they're looking at is to scale the reimbursement by severity. So what that means, Hallowell, I asked Joe DeSilver at the meeting, I asked how bad is Hallowell? Is that the worst school in the state? Not academically, we're talking just facilities. And yes it is. Hallowell right now is probably one of the, is the poorest rated academic facility in the state. Not exactly something to be proud of. However, because our plan involves closing, decommissioning the worst facility in the state, we get extra points. Extra points means higher reimbursement rates. So right now, where the district, because of our the socioeconomic standing, is a 35% reimbursement. Because we're closing one of the worst schools in the state, again, facilities not academic, we could go up to 40% reimbursement for the related projects, the addition to NSES, the reconfiguring of the grade levels. Because we're closing one school and we're moving students and utilizing existing space into other facilities, we get more points. We're not looking to build, we're looking to just utilize more efficiently the facilities we have in place. So now the 35 could become 40, could become 45% reimbursement. And there are other things wrapped into it, energy efficiencies, taking care of stage priority two items in the process. We could go up to 48% reimbursement. We could go up to 50% reimbursement. So that's some of the incentives they're putting into place. The other piece they're putting into place is that, well, it already exists. There are low interest loans available from various housing authority groups. That a lot of districts, they borrow the money up front, they take care of their priority ones and twos, but they pay it off over a 10-year period, usually at about 1-3% at the most interest rate. Additionally, there are other incentives that the state is looking to apply towards districts that are looking to improve our facilities. So we know the governor budget is coming up. It's going to include incentives for warm, safe, and dry. There's word out that the state is looking at floating a bond for monies that would be available to districts to maintain and fix and improve their facilities. So that's where we stand right now. So over the next couple of months, we have a very heavy lift with a lot of engineering, a lot of architects. As we get the information, we'll be sharing it. As RIDE continues and the government, the state continues to develop their incentives, we will also share them back. But come March, February 1st, I'm sorry, when we're looking to submit our application, it's going to be very comprehensive, very far-reaching. And hopefully, we're designing it in such a way that we're going to be eligible for a lot of reimbursement money coming back to us. So that's it in writing. I'll post it up on the website if anybody wants to take a look at it, and we'll just continue doing the updates. Thank you.
Superintendent, just for the record, I'm Stacker. So obviously, when you came in, you were substantially behind the curve. Do you agree with that? I mean, in regards to reimbursement, what SMA has done.
Agreed. We had to follow this process and check these boxes.
So now, if I follow, we're pretty much in front of the curve. We're going to have shovel-ready projects. Probably before, I don't want to say before everybody else, but we're getting in front of the curve now. Let me say that.
Well,
correct.
Not only are we in front of the curve, but there's not a lot of competition right now under the new regs. So there's maybe 10 districts that are in the running for the money for the next go around. And I've been speaking with some of the other districts that had started this process several years ago, and they're looking at canceling what they're doing and try to reapply under these new incentives that we're likely to enjoy.
Great. And I know that we took some criticism for saying that we need $10-12 million worth of pretty much immediate renovations, but by putting that in the SMA plan, we're now in front of the curve. Is that correct?
Absolutely. We're in very good shape.
I just wanted to put that on the record, although I know that, again, we did take some criticism. We hopefully do what we're doing when we ask for it, to make sure that if money comes available, we'll be right there.
We are going to be eligible, as eligible for anything we can get as possible, without being a Providence Central Falls of Pawtucket. You know, for being in North Smithfield, we're going to do very well.
Thank you. Okay, administrative report, what's in the file, I assume, Superintendent?
Yes.
Financial report, file.
Correct.
Old business, the fiscal year 18 operating capital budget. Does anybody have any questions? Anybody have any concerns? Fiscal year 19 operating capital budget. I'm not gonna ask if anybody has any concerns, but does anybody have any questions? Does anybody have any presentations or anything that you want
getting something like that.
Okay.
So we're already, I think we're starting that next meeting forward. Right?
Yes, we are.
I'm gonna do that.
All right. Okay, new business, .3ESLELL, teacher, superintendent?
Yeah, our English learner population has increased beyond the ability of Mrs. Ramirez, our one ELL teacher, to accommodate their needs. So we're looking at minimum of adding a .3 position in order to better service the non-English speaking students that we have moving into the district. Last year at this time, we had 11 students. This year, we have, right now, we have 19. And Ms. Ramirez covers four buildings. And with the high school, with the revolving schedule, it's very difficult for her to actually get to the other district, the other buildings as well. So that's why we need another bot. However, you know, I would say this isn't the ideal solution. I wish we had more of our teachers within the district with ELL endorsements so that they could accommodate the non-English speaking students directly within their classes. So for now, we're looking at adding a .3 position, but I would like to investigate what we can do to have more of our teachers with their ELL endorsements. Three classes. In my previous districts, we used to run them jointly between Kentucky and Central Falls. In fact, Central Falls now, every teacher who applies has to have ELL endorsement. So it's a growing area. I would like to approach the Northwest Consortium, our collective of Smithfield, Barreville, and Lincoln, to see if maybe we could do something jointly within our four districts to help support and bring in more teachers with a familiarity teaching English to non-English speakers.
Okay. Anybody have any questions? Superintendent, this is your recommendation?
Yes.
Hearing none, I'll entertain a motion to add a .3 ESLELL teacher.
So moved.
Motion to be made, seconded. Roll call, please.
Mr. Lombardi?
Yes.
Mr. Bassett?
Yes.
Mrs. Joannes?
Yes.
Mrs. Mayo?
Yes.
Mrs. Mayo, absent. Mrs. Bottom?
Yes.
Motion carries five zero.
Thank you. The award of student transportation, DACO?
We're recommending to remain with DACO for another 2 years. There were three companies that came to our pre-bid meeting. Two companies responded to the RFP, gave us proposals, and DACO was considerably less than the other company.
So the analysis in the packet you did? I received a text from the council president. One of the things that he wanted to see, or he requested, was cameras on the outside of the school buses, so that people who, for one, for safety reasons, and two, people who were speeding by when the lights are on, be able to have some evidence, maybe a ticket then. I don't know, was that, I can text you back. So did you say they were outfitted, or?
So I misunderstood. I thought you meant cameras on the inside of the buses.
I wasn't specific.
So all the buses are equipped for cameras, but we have two cameras that can be moved from bus to bus if there's an issue.
On the inside?
On the inside. Now, the external cameras, there were several different packages for that, and we do have a price to have them on the exterior of all the buses.
Right.
So, however, there are different ways to handle this. We can have them on the exterior of the bus, ourselves, we can integrate it with another company that will pursue the tickets, anybody who violates the stop bus, and they get reimbursed for that, so the cameras don't cost us anything. There are other packages which I know in my previous district, it was done in along with the police department. So the police department also had access to the cameras and would be the ticketing agent. So yes, that wasn't the price that we approved. That's an option, right?
That's correct.
Yeah.
That's an option.
That's an option.
So is that in this package, the options here, that procedure?
Yes, it's on the third page.
All right.
Has this been a problem?
That's what I'm hearing, yes. I don't know personally. So all buses with external cameras, just 1.2 was on.
$20 per day per bus.
You want to calculate?
So we're running 14 buses.
It's $216 a year for each bus.
$216 a year?
Yeah.
Per bus. Per bus.
And that's just.
$513 buses.
So, and that's just for the cameras? Can we?
That price, who is monitoring and becomes the enforcement agent? Does that go to the police?
I would think so. I just wanted to know how much it would be to have a camera. Once we've got that information, obviously, that would be digital and bring to the police department. They can see who it was and take action.
I guess there are several packages on how that's done, you know, that next step. So we could record the person going around the bus, the stop bus, but it's the reviewing of the digital data and then forwarding it to the police. That's the next step.
I understand. I'm just trying to figure. So, well, let me ask. Are you requesting that we pass this tonight?
Yes.
Can we approve the, can we decide on the contract and decide if we want to do it or accept it?
Well, that's what I'm asking.
So passing the contract would be contingent upon working with our attorney to draft a contract with them, and also I'm sitting down with DACO negotiating some of the items.
Right, so today you're requesting us to go forward to award to DACO, but not, maybe not the specifics.
Correct.
Okay. All right.
If I could clarify, Lisa, you said that it would be us sitting down. What do we need to negotiate? Based on this, I have Durham and I have DACO listed on this evaluation. I see a lot of things listed as to be negotiated for Durham, but DACO has a price next to it. So I guess I'm curious as to